Thank you for tuning in to Changing Lives at Crossroads. Get your Bible and join Pastor Tom Pennington for today's message. Trust in the Lord.
We worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You are worthy. You are worthy, Jesus. We worship you. Hallelujah to your name, O King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We glorify, we exalt, we praise your name. Thank you, Lord. Oh, because of what you did on the cross. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. You are worthy of our praise. You are worthy of our worship. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Jesus, I love you, Jesus. You are King of Kings. You are Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. I want to basura te sitor. We praise you, Jesus. We worship you. We worship you. Worship you, Jesus.
Seated, would you turn, greet someone in Christ, give them a hug or a hand of fellowship. God bless you. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise you, Jesus. God is always good, isn't he not? How many are glad for life? Amen. Hey, watch it. Oh, isn't it great to celebrate life, though? I mean, that's what it's all about. Every year is a year of goodness that God provides for us, and we need to celebrate that. We need to remember times that God has done things for us and take time to celebrate not only that another year of life, but thinking back about what he's done. He has been good. I want us to turn our Bibles, please, to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 7. And we're going to look at the theme, trust in the Lord. And I know that you're going to know a lot of these scriptures and a lot of content that we're going to talk about. But I just felt impressed that we need, again, just continually be encouraged to know what the Word says concerning our Lord and how we need to respond to Him. And tonight is that response of trusting the Lord in everything that we go through in life. If that's the message that we hear and understand, or just even just grab a hold of that one little phrase, I can trust the Lord in every phase of my life. And that encompasses a lot. But that means we hold on tight. And we've learned that secret, and we've learned to trust the Lord in the midst of difficulties. And so Jeremiah 17, verse 7 says, blessed is he, or blessed is the man, who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord as well. Father, we thank you that your word is strong, it's powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword. We thank you, Father, that your word speaks to us life. And tonight, Lord, we need that refreshing. We need that encouragement through your word. Lord, as we hear the scripture concerning trust, may our hearts be filled with hope. May they be filled with strength, knowing that you are there for us, and your hand is always outstretched toward us, Father, and we thank you, and we give you praise. So give us ears to hear tonight, and a mind to understand and comprehend, and a heart to receive. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I am very thankful that I don't depend on myself all the time. There are times where I do. And I'll be honest with you. I mean, we're all human. We all think we have capabilities and we have strengths. And we hold on to those. And we know we can do certain things. But you know, every time, I'm just speaking from my heart, every time I get up to minister or teach or do something for the kingdom of God, I am so apprehensive because I don't know, God, you know what's going to happen, and I don't want to just regulate or be a control. I want you to move and have your way done in every service. And so I enter every service thinking, God, this is your time. Use me in some way. And that I'm saying that because that's trust. Because I cannot do anything within my own strength. Jesus said in John 15, without me, you can do nothing. You know, and so I'm just being honest with you. You and I cannot do anything for the kingdom of God unless he empowers us to do it. But we're also trusting him to give us the strength to do those things. You know, once he's called us to do us or place something in our heart to do it, we trust him to help us every day and every moment of that day to go through and meet that purpose and fulfill that purpose that he has for us. I was thinking about the word blessed. I know the word blessed means happy. Happy is the man who trusts in the Lord. Because there's a confidence there. There's a hope. Yes.
Sorry, doesn't it mean favor as well?
It could. It could, but you know they used to describe it as being happy, and I want to say happy is the man who trusts in the Lord, because if God has got my back, I'm okay. Amen. You know, you know, you heard that song that says "Be happy." How's the rest of it? Oh, don't worry, be happy. There you go. There you don't worry, be happy. Why? Because you have trust in what God can do. And so when we go through the situations of life, we're not always in a down-and-out situation. We have a hope and expectation that swells up within us that we say, God, I'm trusting you to bring me through those things. I don't understand why I may be going through this particular thing or why that is happening, but Lord, I'm trusting you to help me through those things. Now, Vanjie, something happened to you 2 weeks ago. Didn't expect it, but it happened. And look where you're at now. You're out of the hospital. You're well. You're getting better. Trusting the Lord. Yeah. You know, that's talking to her through this whole event. Trusting the Lord. Bringing her through the situation. She didn't expect it. Doesn't know why. But God is with her. She trusts the Lord. You know, and that's the exciting thing. That when we don't expect things, we can still trust him. So happy is the man who trusts in the Lord, or his reliance upon and confidence is in the Lord. There's no one else that we can turn to in a time of need that we can depend on. We've seen God's faithfulness. Think about it all your life. Think back the moment, maybe even before you came to that knowledge of Christ, and you've seen the goodnesses of God, and you've seen how God works, and so you have a reliance or a confidence in knowing that God is still going to take care of you in the midst of every situation. And we are exhorted in the Word to put trust in the Lord. This is not just pastor talking and you say, you need to trust the Lord. No, the Word of God says that we are to trust the Lord. Amen. You know, so it's, I want to let God speak for you a moment. God, would you just come in and just speak your Word? And of course, he's saying yes, because he wants you to hear his Word. Here's what it says in Psalm 37, verse 3. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and feed on his faithfulness. Trust the Lord and do good. Every day, get up and trust him. Get up every moment of the day or whatever activity you're in. God, this is your day. This is your moment. I'm trusting you to guide my steps. The steps of a righteous person are what? Ordered by the Lord. And they can't be ordered unless you're holding on to the hand of God and say, I trust you to lead me and guide me.
That's right.
And so we trust him to guide us in every step. So, but it says, and do good. That means we're continually asking God to give us the right judgment to where we can do what honors him and blesses him. You know, sometimes we are always praying, God, bless me. But why not say, God, how can I bless you today? You know, I want to do good today. I want to honor your name. By so walking in obedience or acting in obedience causes a blessing toward the Father. It says, I trust you as my God, as my Savior, and I'm doing good because you've called me to do this. Right. So you're honoring him by your obedience. But I like what this last part says, and you dwell in the land. Where are you living right now? Mm-hmm. Think about where you're living. Right where you're at, that city, that neighborhood that you are in, this state of ours, we're here for a reason and purpose for this time. And but he said, and we're living here. We're supposed to live in the land that God has placed us in. So we are in the land, dwelling in the land. But here we are. We're feeding, or we feed on his faithfulness. Wow. Feed on his faithfulness. We sing the song, "Great is thy faithfulness," morning by morning. You know, they're new and fresh every morning. His mercy is continually being given to us. He is faithful to keep us. He's faithful to wake us up. He's faithful to supply the need. He's faithful to heal the body. He's faithful to allow his word to work in us in conformance to the image of his son. He's faithful in meeting every need of our life. Why? Because we trust him. We trust him, and that faithfulness is manifested in just continually. Again, the psalmist wrote in Psalm 115, verse 11, he says, "You who fear the Lord," he's talking to you, the word is speaking to you, "you who fear the Lord, trust in the Lord. You who fear the Lord, trust in the Lord, and God is their help and their shield." When you put your trust, when you put confidence in the Lord and you trust him, he becomes your help and he becomes your shield. Call it a blessing if you want to. Call it a divine covering, because that's exactly what it is. It's when you and I trust the Lord, God says, they're trusting me, so I want to be their help. Cry out to him right now, whatever it is. Declare what you need from the Lord. If you're trusting God, Lord, I'm trusting you right now to meet that need in my life. It could be healing. It could be salvation. It could be deliverance. It could be an overflow of blessing that you're needing in your life. Whatever you're needing, you're trusting God. And you say, God, I trust you. Therefore, I'm expecting you to be my helper. And God says, I will be your helper. Not only will he be your helper, but he'll be your shield. And wherever you walk, wherever you're doing throughout the course of the day, he puts a shield around you. He's protecting you. You and I are going to be utterly amazed on how often God has saved us from harm. Saved us from ourselves. Saved you from me driving on the street. You'll get that. You know, God saved me from you driving on the street. But I'm saying is that God protects us from all these little things. And we think it's just everyday life and we don't actually see everything. But God has probably stopped us from receiving harm more than we know. Yes. You know, and when he does come to life, thank you, Lord. Yeah. Thank you for taking care of me. Another scripture found in the Psalms is found in 118 of the Psalms, verse 8. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Even the book says that the armor of flesh will surely fail. The legs of a man are weak and useless. The horse is no deliverance in a time of battle. This is all through the Proverbs and the Psalms that the scripture teaches us that you and I cannot rely on the natural things to help us and give us the victory and sustain us. Only God can do that. What about Elijah for a moment? You know, Elijah was called to go by the brook Cherub, and he was to stay there. You know how God took care of him? He fed him in the morning and night with the meat from the ravens that brought it, and from the water that he drank. And he did that for a long period of time till the Bible says the river dried up. You know, he trusted God. He didn't complain. He wasn't worried. God said, go to the river Cherubith, sit there till I tell you to move on, and I'll take care of you. He didn't know how God was going to take care of him, but God began to manifest his care. Raven in the morning with meat, water to drink. Raven at night with meat, water to drink. And all his need was met according to the purpose of God. Because he trusted the Lord. See, God will take care of you, just like he takes care of Elijah. And that scripture is so powerful when we look at that in Philippians 4:19. My God shall supply all your need according to his abundant riches and glory through Christ Jesus. God will supply your need. Trust him with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Get your mind out of the way and let your faith take a hold of what God's word is saying. Trust the Lord. Don't try to reason it out. Just trust him. The moment you and I try to reason it out, forget it. We're going to have this kind of experience. Up and down, but when we trust God, we're steadfast, we're immovable, because he is immovable. He is steady. So it's better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. So don't lean on the shoulder of man. Lean on the shoulder of God. There are promises given to those who trust in the Lord. The Bible says this, found in 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 31. That God, he is our protection. It says this, he is a shield to all who trust him. Again, there's that protection. He is a shield to all who trust him. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities, rulers of darkness, we're in high places. And they are throwing darts of wickedness and temptations at us. But the scripture tells us that God gives us an armament. He protects us. And we can take the shield of faith and we can stand. Having done all to stand, we stand therefore girded about with our loins with truth, our breastplate of righteousness, helmet of salvation, feet prepared for the gospel, taking a hold of the shield of faith whereby we can quench the fiery darts of the enemy and the sword of the Spirit. God has adequately given us the victory. All we have to do is trust him in the midst of all that we're going through and let him be who he is, God Almighty, in our life. There's a great goodness laid up for those who trust in the Lord. Turn back over to Psalm 31, verse 19. There are promises. I want you to see some of these promises that are laid out for us in the scripture. Psalm 31, verse 19. Oh, how great is your goodness, which you have laid up for those who fear you or trust you, which you have prepared for those who trust in you. The blessing there is the great goodnesses of God. God has laid up for those who fear him and trust him his great goodness. See what it says there in verse 19? How great is your goodness. See, think about it. How great is his goodness, which you have laid up for who? Those who fear you, and you have prepared it for those who trust in you. I don't know about you, but I sure like to get a bag full of that goodness of God. I don't know what it's in there, but it says his great goodness is stored up for those who fear him and trust him. I'm not going to try to reason that one out. I'm saying, God, just show me what it is. Bless me if you want to with that. Lord, I want to know what your goodnesses are. But I think I know already. It's life every day. It's the breath I breathe. It's the action I can take. You know, I keep thinking back 2 or 3 years ago when things happened in my life and it just set me back. And I came to that realization of how frail and mortal I am. I can't, every day is just a blessing in saying, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for doing what you're doing in my life. I am so unworthy of his goodness toward me in that, and I am so thankful for it. And so is my wife.
Thank you, Lord.
There's protection or mercy given to those who trust in the Lord. It says this in Psalm 32, verse 10. But he who trusts in the Lord, mercy shall surround him. The person who trusts in the Lord will have mercy surrounding him. You know what mercy is? Protection from the judgment that you should actually get. Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh, I think I'm going to be happy on that one the rest of the night. That's a good one. He saves me from my destruction, from the penalty of judgment, because I'm trusting him. We all probably make mistakes, fall short at various times. There's not one righteous, no, not one. And what the Bible says, there's not one holy and pure except one, Jesus Christ. So when we realize that, man, I really blew it. God, here I am. You put yourself in his presence and you just let him deal with you. That's his mercy. And he deals accordingly and justly. And he restores, he refreshes, he renews. If any one of us have sin, we have an advocate with the Father, the Bible says. His name is Jesus Christ. And he cleanses us from all unrighteousness. So we know that he will take care of us. We just rely on his mercy. Lord, if we have stumbled, if we had fallen, we can call out to God and he will graciously restore us and forgive us. Thank you, that's the mercy of God. He doesn't kick us out. How many are glad for that? Amen. So trust in the Lord also means that we'll be unmovable as well. Psalm 125. Psalm 125, verse 1. 125, verse 1. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved but abides forever. So those who trust in the Lord can't be moved. Let the storms come. Let the sea rage. Let the wind blow. Let the battle begin. I will not be moved. Because I'm trusting in the Lord. As like I said, those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. They cannot be moved, but they will abide forever. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus Christ and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The solid rock. He's the only one that can take care of us. He's the only one that is capable of causing us to stand fast. He is that unshakable foundation, that solid rock. And we who trust in him shall be like him. Hallelujah. And there is safety for those who put their trust in the Lord. Proverbs 29, verse 25 says, the fear of man brings a snare, but whoever trusts in the Lord shall be safe. Oh, no harm shall come near your dwelling. Every tongue that rises up shall be brought down in judgment. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. God keeps you safe. He puts your enemies back on their heels. God is your God, and he will take care of you. Trust in him with all your heart. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And there is peace to those who trust in the Lord as well. I think that's what all of us need more often, is that peace. We're still troubled about so many different things. The pressures of life, the stresses. It could be marriage. It could be home. It could be children. It could be relatives. It could be all sorts of work. It could be church even. You know, we're all worried and concerned about different things. And we can be troubled so much so that we can't really do what God wants us to do because we're so worried and choked by the worry of it that we become unprofitable. But if we can allow the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, rest in our hearts, we can see God do great and wonderful things, not only in our life, but in the corporate body of Christ as well. Isaiah 26:3 says, "You will keep him in perfect peace." And no matter how big the storm is, no matter how difficult it is, no matter how hard and it may seem, God says, "I will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on me, on you, because he trusts in you." When you put your trust in him, there will be a peace that will settle upon you. There's no worry. Why should I worry or fret? You know? Why? There's no need to when God's in charge. And that's what trust is allowing God to be God and be in charge. And we just follow him. So he takes care of us. Our trust in the Lord also brings expectation that God will keep his word. God will fulfill his word. I don't trust him just to say I trust him. I trust him because I know he'll take care of me.
That's right, he will.
And I have that expectation that no matter what I don't see, he sees. What I don't understand, he already understands. And I'm going to trust him. So with expectation, I know that the answer is already on the way. Even while we're yet, the words are even coming out of our mouth, God is already providing an answer to our petition.
Right.
He knows every tear that falls. He knows every heartache that has happened. He knows every distress. And so when we're crying out to God, saying, "God, here I am, I need your help," he's already sending an answer on the way. Turn with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 4. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. And let's look at verses 7 through 10. Second Corinthians chapter 4, 7 through 10. "But we have this treasure in earthen vessels." What treasure? The treasure of the gospel, Jesus Christ. "That the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. We are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus may be manifested in our body." Paul says, "I trust the Lord." He says, "I've been shipwrecked. I've been beaten. I've been stoned. I've been left for dead. I've been in want and I've been in abundance. I've been in all the things of life. And God has always been faithful." Why? Because I've trusted him for every need to be met. He's our God. He is worthy of our praise tonight. He is worthy. So trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him. Let him know that he is the God that you depend on. Trust him. Father, we thank you for your word tonight. Thank you for using this vessel who needs your help so much, so often. So Lord, let's let your word continue to flow into all of our lives as we've heard. Let our ears be attuned to hear what you're saying, and let our heart, God, continue to feed on the word that we've heard. And Lord, as we leave here even tonight, that we will rest knowing, Lord, you're in charge and you're taking care of it. I trust you to do it. So with expectation, we say thank you, Lord, that the need is met because your word is true. So Lord, bless your people. Keep them all safe. Continue to manifest your grace toward them and meet every need in their life. That your goodness is abound toward them. In Jesus' name, amen.
We trust today's message was a blessing to your life. You can reach Pastor Tom Pennington and Crossroads of Albuquerque Ministries at 5200 Marble Avenue, Northeast, Albuquerque, New Mexico, 87110. Or call us at 505-837-1414. Donations are greatly appreciated. A list of DVD and CD sermons is available upon request.
Our pastor refers to the New King James Holy Bible.
You are encouraged, and it's recommended that you set this video to repeat. Invite everyone you know and love, because the kingdom of heaven draweth nigh. You are encouraged, and it's recommended that you set this video to repeat. Invite everyone you know and love, because the kingdom of heaven draweth nigh.